46. Okay, I got my motors finally. I got these triple S 56 104s, 550 kV, and about 200 a pop these were, hence the Vaseline, along with the water jackets, two of them. So I thought I'd crack these open for you. I've been in here already. Okay, there they are. They're a bit smaller than you think, but hopefully two of them. I've already cut the shaft a little bit and put a flat spot so my grub screw can go onto something, keep it from spinning off. And you basically just get three connectors in here for these wires. You get the females of those, so not, you don't get a lot by the motor. 60 bucks each for the water jackets. Yeah, I think 70 mil long. I've just changed the nipple. Basically the nipples were kind of facing, one was facing the wrong way, so I've put that nipple round facing the front here, so it fills up with water as much as possible and comes out the back one. If I have it upside down or one at the bottom, it's just going to run in and run out. So I'm thinking, I don't know, I mean, filling up, you know, yeah, we'll get to that. But I'm basically just going to do a lot of work now, getting these situated in there. Two of everything. So in a way, looking back now, or the next time if I do another one, I'll look at doing a bigger motor with one jet drive. But there we go. We've got two motors and two jackets. MHZ they're called, from Germany, I believe. There you go. MHZ powerboat connection. So that's what I got them from. I'm in Europe, so obviously it'd be different for you guys in the States. You've got it all there. This ultimate jet board, electric surfboard type deal. Hopefully it will be an ultimate success and not an ultimate kick in the old rear end. But we'll see, won't we? Together. Stay tuned, guys. I'm going to be moving on now, getting these motors in the board. All right. Here we go. Back down to the spot. It's winter here and the water's not very warm, but it'll do. This is like the third time now I've been here. Yeah, I've had a bit of water coming in around the back, so I've done some sealing and I blew up an ESC, but I didn't have the water flowing through because I'd left the bungs in the back there. So I got the controller, the Flip Sky V3 controller. Turn this on as well. Ammeter going on, fully charged batteries. So hopefully you can see the jets now, because every time you couldn't see the jets. There we go. So our water's flowing. We've got 30 amps. That's like a quarter throttle, not even. Okay, let's give it a little blast there and it just pushes me all over the place. See, I don't want water coming in now. It seems okay. That was the problem before. I did a bit of silicon in round the place. Okay, takes a second for it to start sucking. The arse is out a little bit. Once I'm on it, it'll be underwater a bit more. Okay, it's going. I'm feeling like it's pushing and letting go. I'm not sure what that is. Oh, RTM, 46. Okay, well, okay, I've still got a little slither of water going in. Just right from here, right from the back edge down here. See them jets. It's doing all right by this water infiltration here. I've got a bit more going on now. Okay, I'm gonna turn off there. I've still got water. I don't know what's going on. I'll get to the bottom of that and I'll be back with more guys. All right, see you later.